Respected Dr. Uma Maheshwar ji, honorable members of the Executive Council, Governing Council, and other organizing bodies, dignitaries in the audience, my brothers and sisters. I would like to extend my best wishes on the auspicious occasion of Vijayadashmi. All the organizers for choosing a different topic on the occasion of the launching of the Sanskriti Adhyayan Kendra. I consider it as my honor to be here to speak few words regarding the main content of the activity. I have been having an association with Sanskriti Foundation during my pravas in Hyderabad. I remember that I have attended at least 3-4 meetings of Sanskriti Foundation. And so I am a bit familiar with the concept of Sanskriti Foundation and thereby the Sanskriti Adhyayan Kendra. I congratulate the organizers for launching such a novel activity, such a unique activity. The intention behind it to have a linkage between public policy and our cultural heritage. All the speakers have adequately elaborated on the cultural heritage of our country, which is great and which is always having its existence in the working of the society. Our civilization is being evolved by these cultural values. Bharat is known for its cultural standings. Bharat, it is always associated with some intellectual things. It is engaged in Bauddhik intellectual development of our people. It has developed some values. I would like to make it in 3 parts where every civilization goes through. To my mind, every civilization basic is some philosophy. We have our philosophy, darshana. And that philosophy guides us in all our work, in all our families, in the affairs that the government and the country has to undertake. Our philosophy is leading to the creation of the cultural values. We always say that whole universe is Our it's a brotherhood, Vasudeva Kutumbakam. We believe in Ekam Sat Vipraha Bahudha Vadanti. One truth is spoken by different voices, but the truth is common, truth is known to all. So there is some philosophy that developed itself through the ages and through years after years. Secondly, we find that in the light of that philosophy, our value system prevails. All our values are in the light of our philosophy. Matruvat paradhareshu paradravyesu drishtavat lokshtavat. Atmavat sarva bhuteshu yap pashyati sa panditaha. Pratyek mata apni mata jaisi hai. Parayadhan we will never take. Atmavat sarva bhuteshu tatvam asi. जो मैं हूं वही आप है, जो मुझ में है वही आप में है। आवर वैल्यू सिस्टम इज डेवलप्ड इन द लाइट ऑफ आवर फिलॉसफी एंड नेचुरली आवर बिहेवियर इज कंट्रोल्ड, आवर बिहेवियर इज अडॉप्टिंग ऑल दीज प्रिंसिपल्स एंड सो वी फाइंड दैट देर इज अ फिलॉसफी टू आवर कंट्री। In the light of that philosophy, our value system is developed. And in the light of the value system, our behavioral pattern is going on there with some cultural values for years together. Our history and our culture, they are inspiring us all the way. And this is called as our chiti, our ethos. Our ethos is in manaviyata, our ethos is in humanity. Swami Vivekananda used to say that we have to spiritualize our humanity. Our all makeup of the body and all our makeup, we have a very great sense of gratitude towards the nature, towards the Almighty. And it is irrespective of religion, irrespective of caste, irrespective of varna. This is being implemented, and so a very silent flow is going on for thousands of years, which tells us about the Indian culture, about the Bharatiya Sanskriti. Essential to have all these contents in different walks of life. And different walks of life are always controlled by the concept of dharma. I am saying this for a simple reason, that we aspire to reinvent our nation. We aspire to reorganize the things in the interest and the development process of our country. And therefore, all our public policies should also be considered in the light of our cultural heritage. Because the public policies have a great impact on society. A simple example that is around us today, that the national education policy, which was referred by Uma Maheshwar Rao and Justice Reddy, this is the best example. And this policy has very clearly said that whatever we have contained in this policy statement, it has roots in Indian culture. It took more than 75 years for us to have our independent policy, because the policy making was divorced from the cultural heritage. Even our education was also under the impact of the colonialism. Britishers left, but British mentality did not leave. I remember Mahatma Gandhiji had said at one point of time, when our independence was just on the verge of acquiring it, Mahatma Gandhi was asked by one of the press correspondents that, now how do you look at our country, our India? Mahatmaji said that, okay, the freedom is there, आई एम हैप्पी। उन्होंने कहा कि अंग्रेज तो चले जाएंगे, लेकिन अंग्रेजियत जाएगी क्या? ब्रिटिशर्स विल लीव दिस कंट्री, बट कैन वी वाइप आउट द ब्रिटिश मेंटेलिटी? दैट कलोनियालिज्म रूल्ड अवर कंट्री फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम एंड प्रेजेंटली ऑल्सो इट इज रूलिंग। वेन वी मेक अवर पब्लिक पॉलिसीज विच आर हैविंग अ ग्रेट इम्पैक्ट ऑन अवर सोसाइटी एट लार्ज, this is to be seen that all our principles which are devoted to our cultural heritage, they are looked into it. In education policy, to a great extent, they could do it. This can be done in industrial policy. This can be done in labor policy. This can be done in our environment policy. Because we have a very respectful sentiments about the working of the society, and that is the ethos, that is the chiti of our country. Pandit Deen Dayal ji has explained the concept of ethos, chiti, That ethos is common understanding. What is good and what is bad? What is acceptable and what is not acceptable? We can see that Nirakshira Vivek. Our Nirakshira Vivek is controlled by our culture. And our culture is having a base of our society. Sanskruti Dharmanishtha hai. Vyakti Brahmanishtha hai. So our culture is always to be seen in the context of the society. And that has to be reflected in public policies also. That public policies are always Sarvajana Hitaya, Sarvajana Sukhaya. Sanskriti Adhyan Kendra, I expect and I request to should give a vast literature available on our Indian ethos in libraries and with so many intellectual people. The background note that I received discusses about dharma. Our behavior and our all these things are related to dharma. There is a great confusion and there has been a great confusion about the concept of dharma. We have never equated dharma with religion. Religion is related to our upasana paddhati. Let everyone enjoy his own upasana paddhati as freely as possible. But dharma is related to society. Dharana dharma ityahuhu dharmo dharayate praja. Praja ki dharana karne wala dharma hai. Samaj ko apne saath lekar jane wala dharma hai. Aur isiliye we have been defining dharma, which is not to be equated with religion. Religion is a different thing. But Britishers have very deliberately and unfortunately very skillfully, they have developed this concept that dharma is something which is very narrow. Dharma is something which is very conservative. Dharma is something which is not to be spoken in public. But dharma has got a different meaning and every one of us has dharma. Mata, matru dharma, pita, pitru dharma, bhata, bhratru dharma, patrakar, patrakar dharma, padosi, padosi dharma. So such a vast thing that should also come in our public policy framework. And so our cultural heritage reflected in public policy framework will change the mindset of people. Because this is closely related with the psychology only. And our psychology basically when we are individuals is related to our culture. Our culture has defined so many things. Swami Vivekananda had said once that language speaks of culture. What is your language? What are your terms? What are your words? What are your phrases? That will indicate your culture. And so in his famous speech, he has said that in any Indian language, you will not get a word like exclusion. Nobody to be excluded. Everything is to be included. Our dharma is inclusive. Our dharma is as wide as anything. And so that culture is also derived from this thing. So our philosophy, we derive our value system and accordingly, our society behaves like that. Several examples we have learned from this corona. It's a great thing that has affected the daily lives of our people. But we find that the seva dharma among our people was as great as never imagined. Thousands and thousands of workers were on the street. But at the same time, people were giving them their lunch, people were giving them medicine, people were giving them some medical assistance. Nobody knows what caste he belonged to. Nobody bothered to what religion he belonged to. So this is called a Bhratru Dharma, Manavata, spiritualizing our humanity as Swami Vivekananda had said. I think a bunch of all these principles will form our culture. And our culture is not a conservative thing to the boundaries of our country. We have always been saying, Swadesho Bhuvanatrayam. Tribhuvan mein jane ki hamari ichcha hai. Hamara Swadesh jo hai, wo hum केवल हमारे भौगोलिक सीमा में नहीं देखते, वी डू नॉट लुक इट इन आवर कल्चर, इन आवर ज्योग्राफिकल बाउंड्रीज ओनली, इट इज ए वेरी वाइड कंसेप्ट, एंड सो आवर संस्कृति अध्ययन केंद्र विल कीप ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन माइंड, आई होप एंड आई एम श्योर दैट इट विल क्रिएट अ हिस्ट्री. आवर कल्चर इज टू गिव इट ए निगेटिव पार्ट, हाउ इट वॉज टेकन बाय द ब्रिटिशर्स. मैकॉले हैड सेड that we can alter this society on any other count but culture. Max Weber had said that we have conquered this nation once, our next conquest will be through culture. Britishers knew it very well, that the soul of this country is in dharma, soul of this country is in culture, and therefore that influence of the British colonialism is required to be wiped out. We can stand our own feet. We have our own way of thinking. We have our own way of behavior. That is to be reinvented. That is to be re-established in all our things. And so, as a teacher, always I feel that as there is intellectual quotient, as there is emotional quotient, as there is spiritual quotient, there has to be cultural cohesion also. To a great extent, a new education policy has considered it that our cultural cohesion should be strengthened, should become stronger, and it can be included in the textbooks. It can be taken in all the books of our learning. It can be accommodated in our learning methodology, because our education says that it is one-to-one. A rudai se te rudai, from one heart to another heart. It's not only the hands that consider, but hands with hairs and hairs with hearts. I think this is absent in the present system. This has to be reinvented. This has to be re-established. And so the policy making will become a very large thing. In our education, we have been adopting the utilitarian approach, upayuktatavad, where we can get good salary, there the students go and their parents ask them to go. There was a big rush for medicine, it is there. Engineering, it is not there. Management, it is not there. Why this shaking? Why this deviation? Because it was not taught properly. Wherever we can get good money, that course gets a demand. If that doesn't get a demand, that course is neglected by the students. This utilitarian approach is there. Knowledge can't stay there for a long time. And we have to impart knowledge, not only information to get a degree. Swami Vivekananda had said, this is not enough to earn knowledge. It is necessary to earn the pragalbhata. It is necessary to earn wisdom. Our education system, as T.S. Eliot had said, that where have we lost knowledge in information and wisdom in knowledge. I think this is also to be reinvested in our education system. Again, we have to go from our present system to Gurukul system in a modern way and learn it. Whenever the policies related to the education come, this has to be considered everywhere. Same will be the case with our economic affairs, our politics, our sociology. Nothing can be separated from each other. We have the integral way of thinking, and that integration speaks of our holistic character. Never we have studied our knowledge with holistic approach, with the approach that touches upon the fields. Now it is necessary to have the holistic approach in education. Our political activities should also consider the basic principles of sarvajana hitaya sarvajana sukhaya. So in every aspect of the social life, we find that this reinvention is done on the basis of the cultural values. Our great cultural heritage can give all these directions for our different bodies that are doing it. Even our Rajadharma has also to follow all these things. Pandit Deendayaji used to say that the Rajadharma has to consider Sarvajana Hitaya, Sarvajana Sukhaya. Not only Bahujana Hitaya, Bahujana Sukhaya. But now the politics has gone in such a way that Sarvajana Hitaya is not remained. Small identities are coming up. Politicians are strengthening those small identities. And a sense of polarization is coming very fast. I think these are the enemies for the society. These are the evils for the society. And considering all of these aspects, our public policy making, public policy framers have to do this. Our Sanskriti Adhyayan Kendra will open several avenues who want to study about our culture. I hope there will be a very good research activity, that research related to our Sanskriti. There will be some fellowships that our students and youngsters can undertake the research on our Sanskriti. And so the whole effort of reinvention is, I know, is very difficult because it has a background of 300, 400 years where everything was tried to be destroyed. Not only disrupted, but it was destroyed. We read about Nalanda and Takshashila, that the great libraries of Nalanda and Takshashila were ruined by those rulers. The same thing after them, the Britishers did. The Britishers did only one. The first thing that our people were made by them forget our history. And that history of our parakrama, that history of our bravery was never depicted as they should have been. And therefore, these are some considerations that came into my mind that if Sanskriti Adhyayan Kendra is going to be a unique activity, the first ever of its own in the field of culture, it has to play a very great role. Our organizers who have been engaged in developing Sanskriti Foundation, they have taken the two papers for the background, Dr. Dattaji's one. I have read that speech, Sureji Soni's speech, because they are thinking about the basic things. And whenever there is a chaos, it is said that go to the roots, go to the basics. I think it is necessary to go to the basics, go to the fundamentals of this great culture. And I extend my all best wishes for the success of Sanskriti Adhyayan Kendra. And I consider it a great honor for me to be invited here and to share some of the points with you. With all these things and with all my limited understanding, I extend again my best wishes. I thank you all. Sabhi ko mera namaskar. Sabhi ko mera dhanyavad.